One interesting thing about the ways that we treat patients today with chemotherapies is that we deliver those drugs in the same way that we delivered them 100 years ago. What my lab tries to do is to use molecular engineering to help those drugs to get to specific locations in the body, to make them more potent, and ultimately more beneficial to patients. We focus on the development of therapeutic technologies for both adult and pediatric cancers. And what we try to do on a day-to-day basis is to use molecular engineering to impart non-natural and improved function to combination therapies for cancer and also cancer immunotherapies. We're trying to develop therapies for cancer that we can turn on and turn off in response to a specific stimulus. And in our case, we're really interested in using light as a tool to control the activity of drugs, both in space and in time within the body. So you can imagine a situation where you might shine a laser or an LED light at a specific location in the body and turn on the activity of a drug and only have it act at that specific location while leaving the entire body not susceptible to the unintended side effects that you would normally see. So we might borrow a piece of one drug that helps it to get to a specific location in the body, and we might borrow another segment from another drug that helps it to stop cancer cell growth, and we might borrow another segment that helps these drugs to get inside of specific cells within the body. And we stitch all of those together using what we sometimes think of as Lego brick type chemistry. As a way to generate a type of therapy that you couldn't otherwise generate using other techniques. One of the things that I think is particularly powerful about the type of work that we're doing is that we're developing therapies that can essentially retrain the body's immune system to be able to recognize and eradicate its own tumors. This is very different than the types of therapies that we've developed over the past 30 and 40 years, and so it's a really exciting time to work in the immunoengineering space.